Private Shimura Kikujiru couldn't hold it any longer. He has to go now. Kikujiru leaves his post and runs for the closest bathroom, but it's dark and the toilets are too far away. He rushes into the nearby woods to relieve himself. Suddenly, he hears angry shouts and the mobilization of troops and vehicles. He doesn't know how, but his late-night bathroom run has just ignited a conflict between Japan and China. Kikujiru sprints around aimlessly in the dark as troop movement intensifies. He can't find his way back to the outpost. Men are screaming. A group of Japanese soldiers advances on the city that sits across the Marco Polo Bridge. The Chinese begin to fire a barrage of bullets, pushing the Japanese unit back. It is absolute chaos. The Japanese regroup and plan a bigger, more aggressive attack. They look across the Marco Polo Bridge at the walls of the city of Wanping. Just beyond it is Beijing, a key industrial city. The soldiers regroup at the outpost where earlier that evening they'd been conducting training drills. Hours go by, and Kikujiru finally finds his way back to the outpost. His commanders look at him with shocked expressions. "What happened to you?" one of the officers asks Kikujiru. "I couldn't hold it in any longer," he responds, his face turning slightly red. "I needed to go to the bathroom." "We thought the Chinese had captured you and were holding you captive on the other side of the wall," the commander explains. "We asked them to let us into the city to see if you were there, but they refused. We took their response as a sign that they were holding you against your will, so we attacked. The mayor of Wanping is on his way for peace talks now." The commander pauses for a moment. "Need to get out of here, Private Kikujiru. You are the reason we demanded access to the city. If it's known that you've been found, we have no reason to move forward with our attack of Wanping. Make yourself scarce until the fighting begins." Dumbfounded, Kikujiru leaves his commanding officers and rejoins his unit. "All I wanted to do was go to the bathroom," he thinks. "Now I might have started an all-out war." And Private Shimura Kikujiru would have been right. This single bathroom incident did not throw the two countries into total war quite yet, but the skirmish would raise tensions enough that in the coming months, Japanese forces would escalate the conflict with China. This would spark the second Sino-Japanese War, with death tolls in the millions. But how could something as trivial as sneaking away to go to the bathroom set events in motion that would eventually lead to war? The answer to the question is pretty crazy. The constant conflict between the Japanese and Chinese during the turn of the 20th century was a result of Japan invading China in 1894. This started the First Sino-Japanese War. It was a short war lasting just under a year, with Japan claiming large amounts of land in China. Tensions remained high for the following decades, but the powder keg that eventually would be lit by Kikujiru's late-night bathroom run actually started in 1931. It was then that Japan had invaded Manchuria and set up a puppet government there. This Japanese territory was led by the formerly deposed Qing Dynasty Emperor. Japan had become a force to be reckoned with in East Asia. At the time, they were on the hunt for raw materials in northern China to boost their industrial productivity, and China was a ripe target for plundering. Japanese ambition was to turn China into a resource base for their further expansion throughout Asia. In fact, they knew that without China's resources, they could never take on the ultimate threat to their ambitions – the United States. The League of Nations condemned Japan's activity and invasion of the mainland. The League even tried to broker peace in the region, but Japan would have none of it. They left the League of Nations, and China refused to recognize Japan's newly created state of Manchukuo on the main continent. This was no surprise, as it consisted of land that had been stolen from China. In 1933, a tentative peace treaty called the Tanggu Truce was signed between China and Japan, but tensions still remained high, and the two nations did not trust one another. This all came to a head during the Marco Polo Bridge incident, which started with Kikujiru's bathroom trip. It's crazy to think how one man's need to relieve himself could lead to a misunderstanding that would spark a war. In 1937, Japan was conducting military drills all around China as an intimidation tactic. They had agreed not to do such things, but were not keeping their promise. This obviously made China nervous, but they allowed it in certain areas to try and keep some semblance of peace in the region. Japan had begun carrying out military exercises in Fengtai, which was the heavily forested area that Kikujiru got lost in. It also happened to be right across the Marco Polo Bridge from Wanping, a walled city that protected the Chinese city of Beijing. The bridge had originally been called the Lugao Bridge and was built in 1189. When Marco Polo returned home from visiting China in the 1200s, he talked very highly of the bridge. Then, when Europeans started colonizing the regions of East Asia, they renamed the bridge after the explorer. On the opposite side of the bridge from Wanping and Beijing, Japan had stationed between 7,000 and 15,000 men. However, this was not the only Japanese military force around the Chinese city. In fact, they had troops at multiple strategic points. It was only a matter of time before things escalated. China did not have the military capability or resources to win another conflict with Japan. They literally couldn't do anything about the Japanese troops that were massing around the city, or the military exercises that they were carrying out. In a feeble attempt to try and prevent further conflict, China asked Japan to give advance notice if they were going to be doing training exercises in the area. This was not an unreasonable request, but Japan did not seem to care, as they rarely gave any warnings before commencing military exercises. Then on July 7, 1937, the bathroom incident occurred. It was around 11 p.m. on the night of the 7th that Japanese officials decided it was time for another unannounced military exercise. The Chinese watched the movement of troops and vehicles from their side of the Marco Polo Bridge. At some point during the training mission, Private Kikujiro couldn't hold it in any longer. It's unknown if he just had a full bladder and needed to relieve himself, or if something he ate didn't agree with him and there was a bowel emergency, but either way, he wandered off into the forest to go to the bathroom. This is when everything began to go downhill. When Japanese officers noticed their missing soldier, they wanted answers. They sent a message to the Chinese regimental commander, Qi Jingwen, saying that they needed access to the city of Wanping to search for Private Kikujiro. Unsurprisingly, the Chinese commander refused. There was no way the Japanese soldiers were going to be allowed to cross the Marco Polo Bridge, enter the walls of Wanping, and have access to Beijing. It just wasn't happening. The Japanese did not take the response very well, even though it's likely that Kikujiro had already found his way back from the bathroom and apologized about getting lost. The Japanese did not inform the Chinese that they had found their missing soldier. In fact, the Japanese were still demanding access to Wanping. The Chinese continuously refused to let them enter. It was late at night, the gates were sealed, and there was no reason the Japanese needed to enter the city. Yet they were unrelenting, so finally the Chinese agreed to conduct their own search for the lost man. This was unacceptable to the Japanese commanders. They wanted to carry out the investigation themselves, and nothing else would do. The Japanese forces prepared the soldiers to attack Wanping and gain access to the city. But here is where things get really messed up. In 2013, Japan's National Diet Library released a series of formerly classified files. In one of them, it was revealed that as Japanese soldiers prepared to attack Wanping, Kikujiro returned. This meant that the Japanese had absolutely no real reason for wanting to enter Wanping other than show their power and make it known that Japan would not take no as an answer from the Chinese. Seeing that the Japanese forces were preparing for attack, China started gathering troops along the walls of the city. At 2 a.m. on July 8th, the Chinese tried to de-escalate the situation. They sent Wang Lingjie, who was the mayor of Wanping at the time, across the Marco Polo Bridge to conduct negotiations with the Japanese. They wanted to prevent conflict at all costs. However, after hours of negotiations, Wang Lingjie quickly returned to Wanping with a distraught look on his face. It was clear the Japanese had no intention of backing down. It is not clear if they informed the mayor that the lost soldier had just been going to the bathroom and had been found. Regardless, they were still demanding access to the city that they had no business being in. Tensions were so high on both sides that at some point bullets started to fly. It's unknown who fired the first shot, but in the early hours of July 8th, a skirmish broke out. This was the opportunity the Japanese had been waiting for. They sent troops across the bridge to try and breach the walls of Wanping. They were unsuccessful and driven back by Chinese gunfire. A communication was sent from the Japanese to the Chinese with the final ultimatum. Either they allow Japanese forces access to the city, or there will be a much larger attack. China knew that Japan would make good on their threat, so they called in reinforcements. Both sides gathered more and more troops. The Chinese had enough of the threats and unexpected drills from the opposing side. They decided to push the Japanese forces further back. The Chinese opened fire at the enemy, who were situated across the Marco Polo Bridge. This was less than an hour after the mayor of Wanping had unsuccessfully tried to negotiate with the Japanese and had returned to the city. It was around 4:50 in the morning of July 8th that full-on fighting broke out and the Second Sino-Japanese War commenced. And although it was not Private Kikujiro's fault for needing to go to the bathroom and then getting lost, the event did lead to the Japanese demanding admittance into Wanping, the Chinese refusing, and the eventual escalation of the Marco Polo Bridge incident. The Second Sino-Japanese War would continue to escalate until eventually it became the Pacific Theater of World War II. Obviously, the war continues to be a point of resentment between the peoples of China and Japan even today. The war raged on until Japan surrendered to the United States in August of 1945, ending World War II in the Pacific. It's estimated that around 20 to 35 million Chinese civilians were either killed or seriously wounded during the Second Sino-Japanese War. On top of that, the Nationalist Chinese Army is reported to have lost around 3 million men during the conflict. The Japanese records identify a loss of around 1 to 2 million military personnel during the war. Could the Second Sino-Japanese War have been prevented if Private Shimura Kikujiro had just held it and not left his post to go to the bathroom? Absolutely not. The war was inevitable due to the aggression of the Japanese military and the high tensions between Japan and China. However, in a crazy turn of events, history has shown that one man going to the bathroom can be used as a justification to start a conflict that eventually leads to an all-out war. Now watch China vs. Japan, who would win? Army-military comparison. Or check out, could Taiwan hold off a Chinese invasion?